Hey, Pete here for Studio Live today, and in this GarageBand for iOS Quick Jam, we're going to be looking at the audio recorder. So once you've used your virtual instruments, you've used your loops, you've been using GarageBand for a while, eventually you're going to want to be recording something outside of your phone or your iPad. So in this video, I'm going to show you how that you can do that. Let's go. Okay, so let's jump into audio recorder. Now you'll notice here that we've got voice, instrument, and more sounds down the bottom, which are just some templates and some default settings we can use for audio recording. But we're just gonna tap on the big microphone icon and go into our audio recorder. Now we can also access those presets that we just saw there by tapping here and going to lead vocals. And now we can go through drums, keyboards, acoustic guitar, vocals, producer effects, fun, and custom. Let's just go with fun and put it on clean for now just to have a basic recording. Okay, let's go from left to right here. The first thing we have here is our input gain. So we can drop that down if we've got a louder source, or we can turn it up if we've got a quieter source that we want to boost the volume of. We can go into more of our input settings by tapping on the little plug icon next to the in, and now we can set the input level here again, or we can tap automatic and GarageBand will automatically detect the volume of the input and set our input gain for us. Our next option here is inter-app audio, where we can use instruments and effects from other apps outside of GarageBand to control our audio recording. We won't go into that in this video, but you can check out the links down below if you want to learn how to use inter-app audio. We have our monitor option, so when that is off, you won't hear back your voice if you're wearing headphones and you're playing back. But if you turn that on, it means that when you're recording, you can actually hear your own voice. So if you're singing along with a guitar or recording, you'll be able to hear what you're singing in your headphones, which is very handy. And the final option here is our noise gate. So with the noise gate off, it means that the microphone or the recording is picking up every sound that's coming in. If we turn the noise gate on, then we can dial in how much sound we actually want to come through there. And the higher that we dial this up, then the more restriction there will be and the louder the sound will have to be before it will be recorded. This is good if you're in a noisy background environment or if you're using things like guitars that have a lot of feedback. You don't want to hear that feedback. You want it to be gated and only record once the actual sound is being played. Each of our defaults will have some basic controls here. So for this one, we've just got tone and squeeze, which is like our compression, and we can set those here if we just want to do some basic controls. However, if we want more control over our audio recorder, we can tap on the mixer icon up the top here, and now we get our full audio recorder settings. Now we have our output. So this is not the input volume, but the output volume. So once the track is recorded, this is how loud it will be played back in your mix. And we also have our panning, so we can pan hard to the left, hard to the right, or anywhere in between. And to go back to the center, we double tap. Next is our mute and solo options. So we can mute this, which you probably wouldn't do if you were recording, or we can solo, which means you won't hear the other instruments or tracks playing back. More ordinarily, you will want that to be off so that you can hear the other tracks playing while you're recording. Next is our plugins and EQ section. So here we can dial in more or less compression, and this will adjust that squeeze option we had over here. And we can also dial in some treble and some bass here. If we tap here on the arrow next to plugins and EQ, now we can access all of our advanced settings. And if you want to learn all about plugins, EQ, compressor, reverb, and delay, we've got videos all about those. So you can check out the links down below. And finally, our master effects, where we can dial in some master echo and master reverb and come in here to select what type of echo and what type of reverb will be applied to all of our tracks. And finally, to record our audio, we tap on the record button. This is a test recording for my GarageBand Quick Jam. To view the recording that we've just made, we tap on our track view icon, and now we can do our editing. We can move this, we can play this back, and then we can move on to record more tracks.
And there you have it, the audio recorder, one of the most useful functions here in GarageBand. Once you start recording your outside sources, you're going to take all of your recordings to the next level. Thanks for watching. If you've got comments, questions, or suggestions, leave them down below, and I'll see you next time.